In order to find the internal loads at point D on the structural member, what we can do is draw an imaginary line and divide the beam into two halves. Next, we can select any one of the halves to solve for the internal loads. Here, we are going with the section DB. Since we have a support reaction at point B, we need to identify those forces. So let's go ahead and draw the free body diagram of the whole structure and first identify the support reactions Px and Py. Here we have a rectangular distributive load of 250 pounds per bit that can be converted into a point load by multiplying it with the 18 feet of the span of the beam. That is coming 4.5 kilopounds. Next, I have a ruler at point A that will have vertical support reaction. And finally, we have an external load of 4 kilopounds in the horizontal direction. Once we have the free body diagram, we can go ahead and start applying the equilibrium equation. So it's starting with summation of forces along the x-axis equals to zero. We have only one force acting along the x-axis of 4 kilopounds. So that will be equals to RBX. Next, we can go ahead and write summation of moment equation at point A equals to zero. Since we are doing the moment at point A, the force AY won't contribute to the moment as it's passing through the line of action. We have our external load of 4 kilopounds that have a moment arm of 3 and making our counterclockwise moment, whereas the distributive load that is converted into a point load of 4.5 kilopounds have a moment arm of 1 and that is making our clockwise moment. Finally, we have Py that has a moment arm of 10. Simplifying, we get the value of Py as negative 0.75 kilopounds. Now, once we have identified the support reactions, let's go ahead and draw the free body diagram of our section and solve for the internal loads. Since Bx was 4 kilopounds to the left and By was negative 0.75 kilopounds going upward, now the distributive loading can be converted into a point load. Since we have a bit of 4 feet, that 250 pounds per foot is equals to 1 kilopounds. Now at this cut, we will have 3 internal loads, N as normal, B as shear force, and our coupled moment of M. Once we have the free body diagram, we can go ahead and start applying the equilibrium equation to solve for these unknowns. So starting with summation of forces along the x-axis equals to zero, here we have just one unknown in x direction. So our normal force is equals to negative 4 kilopounds. Next, we can go ahead and write summation of forces in the vertical direction equals to zero, which give us our value of shear force equals to 1.75 kilopounds. Finally, we can do the summation of moment at the cut and solve for our coupled moment MD. Here, the point load of 1 kilopound with a moment arm of 2 will create our clockwise moment. Next, we have a force of negative 0.75 kilopounds with a moment arm of 4 that is creating our counterclockwise moment. And finally, we have our coupled moment MD in the clockwise direction. Simplifying, give us the value of MD as negative 5 kilopounds fit.